I'm going to finish this series of Season 5 Tournament Champion Cup in China version. Today matchup is GPS versus Shanghai Man. This is the page of ban pick session. I think most of us have the ideas of their decisions. You can express your opinion in comment section so that we can discuss about it. Let's go! Sakuragi intended to be sneaky picky. Akagi directly poked a hole behind him. Fuguda's defensive awareness is good. After seeing Jin's fix and not passing yet, decided to follow him. But too bad, both of the defenders cannot block their shot. GBS can keep taking interfere shot, and they have higher chances to grab the rebounds.
Whatever bounce off the rebound.
They have the ages. Sakuragi can grab miss 3 rebounds. Jun can grab miss range rebounds. Who yet to understand the secret of the rebounds, please click the link on top to find out the answers. Remember, have 2 parts of the videos. On the other hand, blue team didn't have good blocker for shooter. This will be their weakness of this situation. So long Kenji has no ulti yet, Jin can utilize this opportunity to roll his snowball. That's why we can see GPS is keep passing to Jin to take interfere shot. Once Jin has stacked out his zone and got spoudery,
he will be unstoppable.
Blue team is not letting go of this opportunity too. When Jin has not yet unleashed his power, this is the best time for blue team to outscore GPS.
Poor Akagi,
who plays center, who can understand his feeling now. He has the top rebounding stat, but being bullied by 2 molester, he can't do anything about it. Under this kind of 2 rebounders formation,
please.
Do not blame your center for not grabbing the rebounds, and do not use the bad message.
Bad message is for bad people.
It will hurt your rebounder's feeling. I was being hurt too.
So sad.
Nice block from Fukuda. Every block is a good block now, since Jin has yet to make a threes. Sakuragi uses Shinra Tensei to chase back one possession, since Jin cannot find any good looks.
OMG, OMG, this is good.
Fukuda's player sense is amazing. He saw Sakuragi has been extracted by Kenji, means Fukuda's straight line cut will not be stopped. Nice pass and nice shot. This is a good option. Since Jin cannot find his shooting space, assist is a good way to accumulate his energy. That's why Jin another playing style is to bring energy set of abilities and threats.
So touching.
Akagi had the rebound. This is the sad part of Fukuda. He cannot freely move as he wants. A lot of players can restrict his movement by well positioning. He cannot use his combo smoothly anymore. Nice shot from Fujima. Jin has not making any mistake. So long can interfere Kenji shot is a good defense, especially trees. However, Jin might lose his calm. He want to pay back with a trees, and Kenji spotted another wide open chance.
Splash!
While everyone is yet to reposition. Rushing is always a bad decision. Since still got 2 minutes plus remaining, rushing will not help the situation. Now this trees is injuring their score. And now Kenji has turned out his eternal ulti. Monster has awakened. Nice pass to Fukuda for a turnaround floater. Sakuragi is down, no one able to close their distance in time. Since the other 2 are the slow pokes, they are taking back their leads by 7. At the start of the possession, Jin immediately used his ulti. No defenders can shut down this shot. 2 possession game, still got sufficient time to chase back their score in this bad situation. Fukuda has no opportunity, they remain calm and passing around. This time Kenji has sought another wide open chance.
Too fast, too good, too strong.
After Kenji turned on his eternal ulti at this early of the game, GPS has to face this kind of green ghost for the remaining time. It's not easy to defend him. Jin's speed is not able to follow him closely. Sakuragi's face shot has saved them from hell. Still got chance. Wow, nice guess from Jun. Since Sakuragi is down, Jun is the only one who has defending Fukuda's layout, and Jun won the bet. Sakuragi used his ulti to cut down the chase to 3 points, and Jun might have his high chance shot next. Fukuda again turned around footer, and he missed, and he grabbed back his own rebounds. Possession remained. GBS has no teeth in their team, so that Kenji can hold the ball so long. Nice block from Sakuragi. Since Sakuragi is not sitting on the floor, he will be able to go back into the pendant zone to block his jelly footer. Sakuragi again, his step shot allowed him to create enough space for a wide open chance. Now Shanghai Man only has 1 point lead, still got 50 seconds left. Sakuragi's performance has brought back some spirit to their team. If we pay some attention to GPS positioning, we can see how well the Jun is. Not every character can follow Fujima's speed, so Rebounder must take care of his step shot, and onboard defender can focus on his fadeaway. Finally, Jim makes another three. As mentioned just now, after last interfere shot, this try might be his high chance shot. So long the abilities and threats are correct, this kind of probability will not sway too much. Fuguda immediately fight back another two. They still have one possession lead. Sakuragi also wasted no time, only used 1 second to pay back another two. The game is tied. This is because Fukuda also afraid of Jin's tree and double team him, and Akagi was running too slow yet to position at correct location.
Nice one!
Has cheated Jun. Jun Audi was wasted. This possession will decide the fate of these two teams. Who can take away their first win? Fukuda missed his shot. Sakuragi has the rebound. Still got few seconds left. Kenji nearly intercepted the pass. Sakuragi decided to use his step shot to end the game, but it's too late. It's an overtime. Luckily, GPS has changed their plan. Even Kenji turning into green ghost, Sakuragi has taken over the game and helped his team to drag the game to overtime. Nice D from Akagi. But Red Monkey still have ninjutsu. GPS score first. Kenji is too rushed to shoot. Another miss. Jun has the rebound. Akagi not even at correct location to compete. Jin intended to kill the game with a trees, but it's a far bounce rebound. Fuguda again. The ball is just dropped above his head. Fujima missed a wide open trees. Fuguda again dunk over Jun from a missed shot. Now the team is losing their concentration.
OMG, OMG!
Jin has his second time out. It gave GPS 2 possession advantage. Is this the end? Since Kenji's stealing ability is good, they might have chance to gain back their advantage. Don't forget Kenji missed a wide open trees just now. So this 3-point attempt is a high chance shot.
Oh no!
Jin found another wide open trees. Kenji hand is too itchy, and Fukuda ran to wrong directions. This tree is fatal to GPS.
Who is in the air again? Sakuragi!
Sakuragi slapped away their last hope and secured the floor ball. Sakuragi took another wide open shot. Only despair is leaving for Shanghai team. Now what they need to do is close distance passing and do not use their butt to face Kenji. Nice call from Fukuda. Jun is covering Kenji. Fukuda used his first point floater while Sakuragi is back too deep to the paint.
Oh no!
Kenji stole Jin's ball ball from his back. He tried to do a fadeaway, but Sakuragi is able to follow up and he decided to pass. Jin intercepted the pass and secured their first win. What an intense match. That's why Shorthair Sakuragi is a must own character and belongs to my SS tier list. Who has yet to watch the tier list, please click the link on top.
Next game.
This is the band pick section result page. Good choice to separate Kainan's duo and not letting red team to pick another speed rebounder. If not, the blue team will not able to create any shooting space. Same concept, only two rebounders formation is good to keep taking interfere shot. If not better, don't keep trying in normal rank games. It's a selfish behavior. Jun is still pretty good to grab miss mid-range rebound. So long his position is good, his rebounding ability is still insanely good. Sento nearly found a wide open fadeaway, but he stepped out of the effective area, so he passed the ball to Kenji to reset the play. He suddenly used his first point down and is good. Ovan Sento is really hardly to be controlled, especially in competition. Top players have trained up their muscle memory for these combos. If not, they will not able to press these combos that easily. Nice step shot from Sakuragi. This is the reason they banned Oda, so that Jun will be on his disadvantage while facing Shorthair Sakuragi. Although Jun already positioned himself between Akagi and Sakuragi, Jun will still not able to follow Sakuragi's step shot. Nice screen from Jun.
Bloody hell!
Kenji unconsciously go to the right side. He is predicting Miyamasu's step shot. Red team formation is a good and popular. Rival has to allocate two defenders to defend two of their scorers. This is testing how good of their assist in defense. In this case, it's Shorthair Sakuragi. See their coordination. Sakuragi is down. Miyamasu immediately go to Sento without any hesitation. Although Sento has made the shot, but no mistake of their defense. Miyamasu take another interfere shot. Another trees. Defending Miyamasu is really difficult. If we defending him when see him jump, then you jump, Maximum is providing interference. So long the team is supporting him to keep shooting, without second blocker, his shot is hardly to get blocked, no doubt. Miyamasu player has to be good too. Not every Miyamasu can play that good in mind game. By the way, two shooting guards formation is still not recommended in ranked plays. The answer is simple. Who can block second points, dunks or layout consistently if rival is smart enough to counter pick? Especially one monkey can let us suffer. When the monkey know how to leap dunk, it will be a guessing game of our rebounder. Shooting guard has high chance for being bumped away. Even your blocking timing is correct. Their defensive plays are good. Using back to defense is one of the tricks for not falling down. If your teammate is not able to defend Maki or high controls characters, immediately asking to switch. If your teammate has great defensive awareness, they will do it. Not falling down is a very important factor in this game. This match is a very good showcase how to assist in defense. All of the defenders have great vision. Their eyes will not only have one target, they will switch to another target fast enough when their teammate needs help. So long providing interference is a good assistance. Block the shot is the best outcome. Some of the moves that Miyamasu are not able to stop and pass, just like Shosaki. When those moves animation has been shown, you can dump your target and chase after him. Sendo just did a good demonstration. Take a good look of Akagi's defense. This is how a team defense work. If your teammate refuse to do it for your team,
ask them to watch Apui Gaming channel.
Another miss and another face shot from Sakuragi. There is no one can compete with Sakuragi for grabbing high bounce rebound. He is the best candidate. Another great positioning that stopped two dancers few times in a row. So long they are being stopped, it will ruin their rhythm of the plays. Bad call from Sendo, not a good spot to shoot. Miyamasu and Shohei Sakuragi are just with him. Still got 8 seconds from the shot clock. Since Kenji has turned on his ulti, should let him to do another play. It might be caused by controlling error. Nice steal from Kenji. Sendo did another fadeaway and miss. I think they are rushing to score in order to help Kenji to accumulate his ulti, but it's not working. Finally, Kenji recorded 1 steal and 1 assist in this place. He might need another 3 highlight plays for his second time ulti.
Heya!
Shouted by Sendo. Sendo caught Miyamasu off guard and they took over the possession. 1 minute left, 3 points game.
OMG, OMG!
Sakuragi pays him back another monster block. Sakuragi correctly predicted his ulti layout, and they are having the possession. They are trying to use more time to execute a better play. Sakuragi has taken another heavy interfere shot, and he make it. 5 points lead and 45 seconds remaining. It's a 3 possession game. If Kenji are not able to find a wide open 3 chance, this will come to an end. Sendo is not letting this chance to slip away. Both of the defenders are out of position of his second point layout. Kenji has no more ulti, mean his stealing ability might not that fearing. Another 3 from Kainan Shoti, 6 points lead, 30 seconds left. Sendo immediately did a zigzag crossover and dunk, and the defenders are not even know what just happened. Too fast, too flashy. If they're able to secure one more possession, red team might still have chance to tie the game. This time Sendo guessed correctly and Kenji successfully picked up the floorball.
Oh no!
Red Monkey has denied Sendo's shot. GBS has taken away another victory, so long they can protect their Bobo. Jun has tricked Sakuragi, letting him to think he is mispositioned for his dunk, but it's just too late. Kenji has to bet on their trees, but no luck. Looks like Shohei Sakuragi won another MVP status. No wonder he is the most popular character to be picked. Next match is GPS match point. Are they able to advance to semi-final?
Don't talk so much, let's start.
Both of the teams are using back the similar formation. Since ninjas were banned, so Blue Team has selected Awakened Fukuda to replace the spot. This is the job for the one who is assisting in defense. For blue team is Fukuda. No matter how, they are trying their best to help each other. Akagi has the rebound. Kenji created his own shooting space. Blue team has a good start. While the other 3-pointers have not much chances to appear in tournament games, this is because most of the 3-pointers are just pure shooter, even Awakened Jin. Although Jin has new move, pick and pass, still not as good as Miyamasu. As mentioned in my cost effective series of Awakened Jin, immediately pass back is not a good skill. Your teammate not even have sufficient time to reposition at better spot. This is a good scoring trick for Fukuda, but Jun has positioned according to Fukuda's movement, so leaving him no room to score. Shot clock at 5, Kenji has no other option. He takes another heavy interference shot in order to stack out his high chance shot or threats, and his high chance shot has appeared. This is his second threes. Akagi has one few good rebounds from the two rebounders. Give him a light. See that? Who is double-team the three-pointer? Once they pass, immediately follow back your target. This is how should we play defense. But this time, miscommunication has occurred. A wide open threes for Shotty. A bit wasted. Kenji just hit the wall with his face and dropped his bobo. GPS is not giving them a second to reset their defense formation. Sakuragi directly did a dunk. No one is at the correct position. As a Fukuda player, we must judge when we can do a floater, when cannot. Positioning of the defender can tell us about it. If defender has stood at the correct spot for blocking your furthest distance floater, then you know the defenders are smart. Miyamasu sink another threes, who gives them 4 points lead. Shanghai team's scoring modes are restricted. Kenji is losing his calm. Luckily, the rebound bounced to Akagi's location, and he tried another one. This time, their luck is used up. Sakuragi had the rebound. For those who yet to watch my formation choices video, I will briefly explain here. What are the three important factors when we pick a good formation? First is defense. Don't play all weak in blocking characters like normal Hanakata, normal Rukawa or any SG or any point guard, except Maki. We are not all top players in our team. So who can be the one who assists in defense? If no one, equal to bad. Second factor is speed. Do not pick two slow pokes like Hanakata plus one center. It's not working. If I am rival, I will directly pick a speedy point guard like Kenji Fujima or Ryota Miyake, or even a selfishless three-pointer. These two slow pokes will not able to follow their speed and a very easy angle picking them. Then rival team will have a lot of wide open chances. And the last one is offense. Simple and clean explanation. Same, we cannot pick all defensive team too. Someone has to score. Looks like Blue Team has some technical issue. Kenji is becoming a stone. GPS also not letting go of this kind of opportunity. And Merciless stole his bobo and passed to Sakuragi for a wide open shot, giving them 7 points lead.
Are they despicable?
I think not. This is how should it be in competition. You are not the one who caused their disturbance. Kenji is back to normal. However, this definitely affects their morale. Especially this is their last game if they are not performing. Nice one. If Fukuda is not able to break through rival's defensive wall, turnaround footer is always a better option, rather blindly attacking the basket. A blocking monster plus rebound king plus second scoring option of the team go to insanely good. This is Shohei Sakuragi. Just don't keep shooting if the rival know how to defend you. Looks like Shanghai team has given up the game. Surrender ward is passed. GPS won the series. And Shohei Sakuragi won another MVP again.
If you enjoy the content, please give me a like and subscribe my channel. Thank you guys, I will be back.